kiddies, welcome to our English grammar class. And in today's session, we are going to learn about singular and plural. Now, in previous standard, you have learned the same thing. And in this session, we are going to learn about some extra rules, how to change a singular naming verb into a plural naming verb. Are you ready? So without any delay, let's move into our today's class. See here, first of all, you have to know the definition of singular noun and the definition of plural noun. See here, what is meant by singular noun? Refers to one of something. Okay? If a noun refers to one thing, then it is known as singular. Okay? If you take anything, you can take anything like a chocolate, book, water bottle, etc. So if you are referring one of something, then it is known as singular. Whereas what is meant by plural? Plural. Noun refers to more than one of same thing. So if you are taking a book, when it is one, then it is singular. Then if you are taking a book more than one, that is two books or three books or four books, then it is referred as plural. You should take one more than one of same thing and not the different things. Okay, va? So more than one of same thing is referred as plural. So this is the difference between singular and plural. Now we will see some of the rules how to change a singular noun into plural noun. See the first rule given here, to change nouns ending with. So there are certain words which ends with certain letters. So what are the letters given here? SH,
CH,
DGE,
yes,
yes, yes,
yes, yes,
is
that,
is that,
yes,
yes,
is that, is that.
So if a word ends with such letters, then the plural form we should add what? We should add ES to the naming verb. So I repeat it again, to change nouns ending with SH, CH, DGE, yes, 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 Z, yes, Z, then the plural form we add ES to the noun. See the words given here, bridge. So bridge, it ends with what? It ends with DGE. So you have to add ES to the plural form. So the answer is bridges, because it ends with DGE. See the second example here, it ends with what? It ends with CH. So if it ends with CH, the plural form should be, we should add ES to the noun. So match plus ES. So what will be the answer for it? Matches. The answer is matches. So the first rule is clear to you, I hope. See here, to change nouns ending with SH, CH, DGE, yes, SS, Z, X, Z, Z, we have to add ES to the singular noun to change it into plural noun. This is our first rule. Coming to the second rule. For nouns ending with what?
Consonant plus Y.
Okay? If a noun is ending with consonant plus Y, then the plural is formed by changing Y into what? Y into IES. So this is our second rule. First of all, you have to know what is consonant and what is vowel. You know there are five vowel letters in English alphabet. What are they? A, E, I, O, U. So these letters are known as vowels. So apart from these letters, the remaining letters in the alphabet are known as consonants. So our second rule is, if a noun ending with a consonant plus Y, then the plural is formed by changing Y into IES. Okay? See, Y. So you have to add I, E, S. For that you have to cancel the Y and the answer is ladies. Okay? So see the second example given here again. Fairy. Here it is all. It is a consonant and it is followed by Y. Consonant plus Y. So according to the rule you have to add I, E, S. So Y is cancelled and here the answer is Paris. Okay? So this is our second rule. I repeat it again. See here, for nouns ending with a consonant plus Y, the plural form is formed by changing Y into I, E, S. Okay? Coming to the third rule. If a noun ending with vowel plus Y, the plural is formed by adding what? By adding yes to that singular noun. Okay? It is very simple. So if a noun ends with vowel, for example, A, E, I, O, U plus Y, then the plural is formed by adding yes to the singular noun. See some of the examples here. They. Here, A is a vowel letter plus Y. Then we have to add yes to the noun to change it into a plural form. So the answer is days. Okay? See the second example given here. Monkey. Here it is a vowel letter plus Y. Okay? So you have to add simply yes to the plural noun to change it into a plural form. What is a plural form? Monkeys. And the third example is boy. So here O is a vowel letter plus Y. So you have to add S to it and the answer is boys. Boy is a singular form and boys is a plural form. So this is our third rule, that is for nouns ending with vowel plus Y, the plural is formed by adding yes to the singular noun. Okay, coming to the last rule. Most nouns ending in F or
F-E
form the plural by changing F or F-E into what? Into we, ye, yes. Okay? If a word, if a noun word ends with F or F-E, then you have to change it by adding we, yes to the singular noun. See the examples given here. The first one is Y, the second one is knife. See here Y. It ends with what? It ends with F-E. So you have to add V-S to the Y. For that you have to cancel F-E and you have to add V-E-S. Wives. See the second example here. It ends with F-E. Nine. So you have to add V-E-S according to the rule. And here F-E is cancelled. And the answer is knives. So this is our last rule, that most nouns ending in F or F-E form the plural by changing F or F-E into V-E-S. So in this session we have learned the definition of singular and plural and the four rules how we can change a singular noun into a plural noun. I repeat it again. See the first rule, to change nouns when it ends with SH, CH, DGE, S, SS, X, Z, 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 then you have to add ES to the noun. And coming to the second rule, for nouns ending with consonant plus Y, then the plural form is formed by changing Y into IES. And coming to the